This broadcast is about the Dutch language. And to make it easy, I have looked up on Google Maps, or maps.google.google. This is the place where we speak Dutch. It's a very interesting piece of soil. This is of the to the northwest of Europe, and here we have islands. They are called Waddeneilanden. You can actually walk if you know the right. What is it called? Getijden. If you know when the flood comes, then you can walk to these isles. I walked to Ameland. That's over here. I have worked on Schiermonnikoog. And Rottumerplaat is also Dutch. And Borkum, that is German. Germany. You have this border line here. This is the Dutch country. Nederland. Really meaning the most downward place on earth. Scheemda. I worked there for a customer. What I would like to see is that this piece of territory, it is all about a delta. There are rivers floating along, and they, the mean people, the Catholic kudde church. I would have to make a really good English translation of that word. But what we need is that a wholeness arises with all these rivers, and then we take over from here, the Eems, until there, the Schelde. And we have to unite. Why is this? Why did the Heere Heere, Lord Lord, gave us such a beautiful language when living in such a terrible water over flooded piece of world? Well, I don't know that. What I do know is that here in Holland, let me switch to Dutch again. Here in Holland, we have a lot of immigrants. People with a color that did not went to Spain or to the Sunbench. It's called Sonnebank. They are brown of their selves. And I don't care if someone went to the Sun Center and paid €7 to get a tan, or that he went to Morocco and got a tan. Yeah, what do I care? And there are people who came from Morocco and they have a tan, which is really standing on. I don't care. care about what people say. And what is happening now in Holland is that we speak English in public, like I am doing now. And that is a new experience for me. We are empathic in a way that we would be able, like to be able, to speak another one's language. Ask for that with Mr. Putin, the Russian a-hole. Well, we in Holland have our problems too, of course. And Putin is the problem of the Russians. If the Russians one day would like to learn to speak Dutch. The language Dutch is not the language that is pestured by the government, speaking about language rules like D and D2. DT, sorry, 1D, double D, DT, do you need a silent N, like in Nico? When can you leave out the silent N, and when not? This is childish. The Dutch language is not so hard. How they speak in The Hague, for instance. That is a really nice way of speaking. Rotterdam, we say. Rotterdam. They have a different sound in their throats. The same holds for Nijmegen and Os, Tilburg, Breda, and below here. Oh. These isles. And then in Belgium, here it stands Ghent in American or English. Yeah? We say Ghent, and the people there say Hent. Brussels. Brugge. Bruges. Our language can be understood up until Hamburg, no problem, Rostock, maybe even here, in Stargard. The language is called Dutch. What the American people name German, we call that language Dutch. High Dutch. Hoog Duits. Die Deutsche, ja, die allemaal, die naam van. Wij zijn niet. Dan gehen wir weiter. We speak the native language, like here. It's called Frisian. Frisian. Leeuwarden, meaning city of lions. Drachten. They speak Frisian here. And in Frisian, the substance that we call in Dutch, deeds, whatever, cause, noem dat, cause. What you need is a cow, and you're gonna fiddle with the nipples of the cow. Let me fondle your nipples. Fondle, yeah. You have to fondle the nipples of the cow, and then you get milk. And in Frisian, that is called cheese. English, anyone? English is a constructed language, partially based on Frisian. And you should not learn your children to speak English unless it is necessary to get along. Because we all wanna have to survive. Turning back again to Dutch. I visit bars. I am neither proud or ashamed that I visit bars. I just visit bars and I pay my account. I live here in Arnhem. Let me look where I live. I live about here, and the bar that I visit is over here. This street is called Wezenstraat, meaning the street of people who do not have parents. Orphan Street. There I was told by an immigrant, someone who was taken here, and I love him very much. He can play the trumpet like nobody else. And I was sitting around here, I believe. Yeah, about here, around here. And he told me that the thing about Dutch is that the Dutch, they speak from various parts of their torso. Torso meaning your chest, reaching out to your dicky, klitje, Miley Cyrus, you know? Your torso. And Dutch, the Dutch, they can speak really low. What are you talking about? You get? That is hard for many people to switch over to the learn of the chakras. The first chakra resides about 3 centimeters, 1.5 inch below your anus, the Muladhara. The second one resides by your penis or your clitoris. Clit. Your Hill of Venus. That is the lowest part of your speak. This part of your speaking, your low speaking, like in really, essentially, basically going low. It's really good in that way to talk to dogs, even cats. The second way of speaking is around your next chakra, I believe, and it is your solar plexus. It is your, it is the point in your body, the location in your body that you should keep still when you are doing fighting, like in technical, artly fighting, martial or arts. And you can, I will do it now, you can raise your voice to that place. You hear me speaking? And the third one, not meaning that there are not more than three ways of speaking, of course. You can also halfway between your solar plexus. You can point it out. Do some martial arts. Do some judo training, karate. You will know it between no and nothing. The high parts of your lungs, your torso. You can always use your dead arm, you can't come on. It's the high voice. And we the Dutch, we control all three. The good Dutch, of course. We have blokes. B-L-O-K-E-S over here, called Jan-Peter Balkenende. And they are not so good in Dutch. We have a guy here called Geert Wilders. Ridiculous names. I'm ashamed to share the same country with them. And I can never apologize for the birth of my daughter, because she would always, in the long end, will say to me, you should have known better than to receive me in this butthole. But then again, let's not be worried. My daughter was four years of age. And she would not want to, she could not catch the sleep, started crying, which was annoying. I had done my whole days of work and wanted to look some TV in silence. And she said to me, I wish I never had been born. That really pissed me off. you get. That is not the issue. The issue is that speaking funny languages like angel speak, English, it's a kind of a no-go. Essentially, basically, what not. The Dutch language teaches people to speak from their Svadhisthana chakra, from their lower belly, up until their lungs, and shut the F up when you have nothing to say. For instance, I have a Bosnian friend. She is female and has a daughter, 2 years older than mine, my daughter. She knows Russian. And she talks to me over the phone just like Vladimir Putin does to his journalists. Let me explain Vladimir Putin Russian. It goes something like this. Dear reporters, I am the president of Russia. I have an announcement to make. I have invited you especially because I can trust you that you will write down the truth, not from my mouth, but from your experience and your evaluation. I want you to write down what I say in just the way that you think that you are participating in the independent media. Or else, I could continue for 15 minutes, Vladimir Putin did that. Or else, if I do not have an independent media, where would I be as the president of Russia with an important notice? I depend on your independency to exactly tell to the people what my message is. And I do not want you to write down exactly what I said just now. I want you to write it down like you were that is not Dutch. Vladimir Putin, had he been a Dutch, he would have been chop chop. At least by some very funny Dutch comedians, because we know how to laugh. The second reason why Dutch is not difficult but complicated or difficult is our control of not vowels but the other let me look it up, let me be an a-hole. Vowels definition. A vowel. Okay, and under the other one, a non-vowel. I'll call it. Ja, wij noemen dat gewoon the vowels you can leave out. Anything that you say, you can say it without using a vowel. What is a consonant? Is that a... Yeah. Consonants, exactly. Oh, we are the best in consonants. The Dutch. For instance, the letter G, the seventh letter of the alphabet. We can pronounce the G in many ways. G, G, J, the consonant R. We are able to speak the English R or the American R. We have a in Hilversum. There's this Hilversumse R. R. Als ik die R had. If I had that R. You can continue on. Huh? So the Dutch have this moving between their belly and their upper chest and the complete control of consonants. Medeklinkers. And this needs a good control of your voice, your vocal. That is the problem with Dutch. I think that I am able to switch back to, you might call it pagan Dutch or old Dutch, Dietz. We name that. Dietz, we name that. The old language. And we still use that in Holland. We have all these immigrants and they do not know the difference between die and dat. The and that. Dutch is a sexual free language. We speak of the concept of mens. Mens meaning a conglomerate of molecules able to think. A sack of molecules able to think. We call that mens. We differ between a concept like mens and crocodiles, of crocodile or mosquito. I kill a mosquito before you can spell Mississippi. If I would like to kill a mosquito. Because I am mens. We also have the word man. Like in the Bible, it is written, on the sixth day, God created man. The concept of man is not that you say that a person who is man is male. That is a really hard nut to crack. That is why everybody should start to speak Dutch, to get rid of these sexual healing, sexy stuff. Man is the sack of molecules, able to think, and most surprisingly, thinking. And you do not need a dick to think. You do not need a clit to think. You do not need your pinky to think. You need to think. Because that is what the Lord gave to you. So don't be an annoying crocodile hanging in the water and complaining about why are there not fishes swimming into my beak? Silence. The third reason why Dutch is such an important language is that the Dutch shut up. You only say what you need to say, and for the rest, shh. I believe you that one day people will learn to speak Dutch or appreciate to speak Dutch or to appreciate that there are people speaking Dutch. No sexual remarks. Here in Holland we have the and hat, it, the tent, and it had house. A tent, like in a piece of textile with some ropes bound to a tree, so you will not get wet when it starts to rain while you are sleeping. A piece of cloth. It's called the tent. And a het huis. The house is a worthy thing. It has a lavatory, it has a kitchen, a place for children to sleep. It has something that is to be protected. Speaking about male and female, we say de man, meaning de bloke, and de vrouw, meaning the bitch, the wife. Het kind. Because if you are a bloke, then I do not have to care about you. You're just like the tent. A temporarily awareness or something, huh? If you are de vrouw, then I do not have to care about you, because you are the. On the other hand, if you are het kind, there we switch over in Dutch, yeah? This, the man, the woman, het kind, it child. That is a different story. So everybody should learn to respect Dutch. And my meaning is that the immigrants, especially the immigrants, really appreciate Dutch. They find it a warm bath of semantics, to put it philosophically. The last thing about Dutch, and then I will shut up, was also an immigrant, or his parents were immigrants. He could really speak lovely Dutch. He said to me that the Netherlands, let me focus out, it was here in the bar, in the Orphan Street, but that the Netherlands are the council of the world. It were his words, not mine. So, everybody, be silent. We, the Dutch, are going to take down the papacy, the papacy. It's gonna be all over. But you will have to learn to speak Dutch. I do not know how I can make it much more funnier. Thank you for listening. And in the Hamburg, the city over here, Hamburg, I say tschüss and dag lievers.